Okay, in this video I'm going to go over one way that I do fletching. And these are turkey wing primary feathers. I find that these work better than the secondary feathers with the type of fletching I'm going to do right now. What I'm going to do is peel off these vanes from the coil itself. And the primary wing feathers tend to work better, I find, because you get a lot more of the membrane, I guess they call it, that comes off with the vanes. It makes it overall more durable. And I get them wet before I peel them. It works better that way. And I'm sure many of you already know how to do this, but just grab some of the vanes and start peeling back, almost at a 90 degree angle. I've let these are damp. I just dip them in water and let them sit there for about 5 minutes to let the water soak in. And just peel off what I call the vanes. And all you're left with is a quill and some of the other veins on the other side. Now it's fairly durable when it comes off the primary feather. This is pretty substantial here, this membrane. So it works very well. Again, just grab a little piece off and start peeling. Almost at a 90 degree angle. And it's damp, remember. And that's about it. I'll show you how I cut these and trim them and attach them to the arrow shaft in the next video. Okay, what you're looking at here is some reed arrows, and I think I covered all the steps in making a reed arrow except for the fletching, how I do the fletching. Most of the time I use turkey primaries with goose feather fluffs in the front. And sinew, either leg sinew or backstrap sinew to wrap them down, and I don't glue them down in the middle. Usually the feather is durable enough that it will last quite a few shots before there's any chance of this breaking. The only thing that happens is when it becomes damp, these may raise up, and it can cause a little bit of noise when the arrow is flying when they raise up like this, so you may want to glue it down if you anticipate hunting in damp weather. Anyway, these are some new arrows that I made. The tips are harrow tips. The size on these are very small. Let's see if I can get a ruler in here. They're about an inch long and about 1/2 inch, like 9/16 wide. And that's a pretty typical size for a harrow point out here in West Texas. And these are fastened on with a little bit of pine pitch and buffalo backstrap sinew. This is backstrap sinew here. And on the ends, I just kind of used a black Sharpie to do a design on there, nothing major. This part the fletching area, or the shaftment, is all is sanded down so that all the wax is taken off. It's not nice and shiny and waxy like this part. I take all the wax off so I can paint it, and also if I want to glue the quills down, they'll stick. So what I'll do, I'm going to cut it off here. I'm going to trim these to match the other arrow. Trim these fletchings and leave about about an inch or so on the end, on each end, for tying it down. And I'll make nine of these fletchings. That's it. Okay. I'm just going to I'm going to cut off this delicate part in front here. Cut about an inch inward. And then I'm going to measure the length of these other fletches. Test these scissors before I made the video, so they're kind of dull. They still work. Now this part can just be fold it down when you wrap it, or you could trim it off. And I'll roughly trim off the majority, or a lot of the feather, before I mount it on the arrow. It just makes it easier to trim it in the end. And before I attach this, I'm going to soak it in water. I'll make 9 of these for those 3 arrows. And what I normally do is I start in the back. Now sometimes you'll see Native American arrows with this quill or this membrane folded. And what they do is they just kind of mount it on there backwards, wrap it and fold it, and then when you pull it to fasten it in the front, it provides a very good anchor when it's folded like this. It won't slip out of the wrapping. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to lay it down with some glue and wrap it just flat like this. I won't be pulling very hard on it, and then I'll wrap the front. Now one thing I'm going to mention is the Native Americans trim these feathers in very different ways. In the Southwest, you usually have a what I call a rectangular type fletch squared off in the back, and sort of rectangular looking, but you can also trim it. I've seen feathers trimmed with some of the veins left in front in the Southwest, and the way I do it is I leave a fairly good amount on there. and I just taper the tips. And the reason why I do that is because it just falls better, or it looks better on the final arrow, to have it real thin at the tip and thicker here. And if you happen to, when you're wrapping, if you happen to wrap a little bit of it, you're not going to catch the whole thing. You're not going to catch this whole thing. You may catch some of these little veins in the front only, and it'll still look good. And you don't have to trim it square off. You can leave it natural. That's it. Okay, this is a goose feather, a white goose feather, and it has down in the front here. And this is what I use for the fluffs in front of the fletching on my arrows. And what I do is I just peel some of these off and roll it with maybe a little bit of water, and take a little bit of glue and glue this so it stays together. I've got some fish glue in the bottle here. And right now it's about 55 degrees, and this glue is still liquid. It is running slowly. It is more liquid at a higher temperature, but one thing I like about fish glue is it does stay liquid in lower temperatures, and it does give you a little more time to work with, as opposed to high glue, which gels quickly, or gels at a fairly high temperature. So what I do is I just make a bunch of these, one for each fletching, and set those aside for when I'm going to wrap the fletching. Okay, I had a bowl of water here, but it looks like all the water leaked out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you guys how I waterproof this. Just take my heat gun. It's already got some residue from some paint that the kids and I made actually last year. I'm going to dry it out a little bit with the heat gun. It's got some cracks, some really big cracks, so I hope this works. I just dropped in some rosin. It's cracking because it's cold. What I'll do is I'll just heat this up until it gets into a liquid state and swish it around in the bottom. might have put a little bit too much in there, but that's okay. As long as it holds water, that's what I'm worried about. I gotta watch I don't get it too hot because it can catch on fire. It's starting to smoke a little bit. And I gotta watch that I don't get the bowl too hot because the pitch will get down through the cracks and it'll get on my hands. That won't be any fun. Okay, that should be good enough. I don't need to hold too much water in this. Spread it out a little bit. That's good enough. This is just pine rosin, that same kind of stuff you can use on violin bows. And I just buy it from a soap supply company. Anyway, I'll just let this cool down and put some water in. But I just wanted to show you how I did that. Okay, hopefully the water will stay in there. And what I need it for is just to soak the feathers. Get them wet. Let them sit there for a little while. And also to soak the sinew. For wrapping the fletching. Now this is backstrap sinew. And it's very easy to separate. Put it in the water. Okay, just get it wet, and you don't need to soak it for too long, just get it wet. Now this is still a little stiff. I may need to soak it a little bit longer. Seems to be okay. It's softening up pretty good. You don't need it to be, you know, really, really soft or slimy. You just need to be able to tie down the fletching and pull on it. If it's too slimy, it'll be difficult to grip when you're pulling on it when you're wrapping. And it may also take a long time to dry. So that's good enough right there. And let's see if I can get this on video without taking too long. Take some glue. Actually, I'm going to put it on the edge of this bowl. That way it'd be easier for me to get some glue when I need it. And if it dries, I just dab a little water on it and it should reconstitute it. So I just dab glue on the end here. Grab some of these fletchings. Now the way I normally do this is I use the knock actually as a guide to know where to put the fletching. This first one goes in line with the edge of the knock there. And I'll just wrap it once for that one. The next one goes right on the other side of that knock, right along the edge of the other side. One wrap for that one. And this last fletching goes right in the middle. I line it up with the paint on the back. Right in the middle here, between the two openings of the knock, is where I put this one. Now I gotta be careful to keep these straight. The quills straight. And I don't hold the sinew in my mouth or anything. I guess I just do it the hard way. End of the sinew there. I'm gonna make sure I tie that down or I get that underneath the wrapping. Get some more glue. These are lined up. I don't know if you can see what I'm doing. I'm just pulling on them a little bit, making sure they're lined up where they should be. It doesn't really matter too much if it's off a little bit. And I'll wrap it again with some more. But I'll let this dry a little bit and set before I wrap the front. Okay, it's been a couple minutes, and when I lay these on, I just lay them on straight. I pull them straight. You can put a helical twist on these, but it'll still fly and twist even if you lay these on straight. So I just find it easier to lay it on straight. Get some sinew. Get some glue. Find where the these tips are going to be laying down. And dab some glue on the front here. There's my puppy dog. Okay, let's see. I'm just going to do very similar procedure like the one on the back. One wrap. Line it up. There's my arch nemesis. Just made off with some feathers. Okay. Take the next one. And the next one. After I got a few wraps around, I pull on them to align it and straighten it. Not too hard because it will pull out from here. You don't want to pull too hard on the front. Just enough to get them lined up and straightened out. And, you know, flush up against the shaft mint. You want to just grab a little bit of the end there and pull. You see how that flattened out nicely? Grab the end, pull. He keeps bumping into the tripod. Line them up the best you can. Look, make sure that the spacing is equal. I mean, it doesn't have to be perfect, but just keep an eye on the spacing and then do your final wrapping. There's an end of the sinew there. I just grab it and wrap it together with this. This piece. And as it's drying, I just flatten it with my fingernail and roll it at the same time. Little pieces sticking out. The second wrap going over this will cover that. The second wrap also anchors these fluffs. these fluffs are very delicate, so they'll stick to your fingers and be a real nuisance until you get them tied down. Let me take care of the dog first. He's eating up all my fluffs and feathers and stuff, so let me take care of him and I'll get back to the video. Okay, let me get these fluffs on here. Just take a thin wrapping of sinew. Get this one wrapped down. Now it doesn't really matter where you put these fluffs. I prefer to go in the middle, between the two fletchings. But you can put them in front of the fletchings. Wherever. I'm trying to do this with sticky fingers. And watch the camera, make sure I'm in the center. Okay. And after you do a few of these, it goes faster. You'll get the hang of it after a few. And fill in the water. Just grab the other one. Wait till that fluff dries out a little bit before I use it on the next arrow. Hopefully you can see what I was doing throughout this process. And the last step is just to wrap down the fronts of the fletching. Clean up this, or align the fluffs a little bit. It doesn't have to be perfect. I may go through and put another wrapping on just to wrap it down a little bit better. And then I'll wrap this again also. And then trim these little pieces that may be sticking out. I don't need very much for the second wrap, so I'm just going to take a very thin piece of sinew, a little bit of water, a little bit of glue, and just wrap it on the ends here, on the end. Just below the base of that nock. Backstrap sinew is nice because it's fairly long. Gives you a lot to work with. A little bit more glue. it down. You don't need to smooth this end down. It's actually better if it's kind of rough on that side, but this side you want it nice and smooth so you don't feel the when the arrow passes your hand, you don't feel anything. If it's really rough here, it'll scratch your hand up. And if you don't anchor down the very tips of these fletchings, they could also scratch your hands. That's about it. The last step is to trim the fletching down. Looks like the bowl is holding water. So that worked out well. What I'm going to do now is trim the fletching down to the right height. It's pretty much there, but it's a little bit jagged. So I'm going to even that up. What I do is I just make sure all the vanes are lined up. It's still a little damp right now, which is good, because as everything dries, it'll tighten up. And you can see this part needs to be trimmed down. And again, it doesn't have to be perfect. Just as long as you're happy with the way it looks, that's what's important. The Native Americans used pieces of chert or flint to trim the feathers, or they would just burn the feathers down with a hot coal on the end of a stick, or something like that. Anyway, I just eyeball these. You can measure them to make sure you've got the same height, but I always just eyeball them. It's a lot quicker. It kind of gives it that rustic look also. So yeah, I am going to wrap one more time around on these fluffs to flatten them down a little bit more with just a small piece of sinew. We're already at 8.5 minutes. Let's see. I'll show you what I mean. If I can get this to separate. My fingernails are very short, so I can't get my fingernails in there. Oops, let me see. There we go. Just take a very thin piece. A little bit of water, a little bit of glue. The glue is on the rim, remember, and just apply it to this sinew. get the wrap started. And I'm just going to anchor down that those fluffs a little bit more. Yeah, that's good enough. And there's a little bit of a depression in here because of the node. I'll just wrap some extra sinew in there to kind of get rid of that little depression in there. I didn't anchor down that the other end of that piece of sinew, so it's starting to unravel a little bit. Let's go this way with it. Hopefully this is in focus, and that's about it. Still damp, I'll just let it dry. If you look down the end, I don't know if you can see, it has a little bit of a helical twist to it because of the shape of the feathers, so it will spin in flight, but the fletchings are pulled straight, and they're not perfect, but it doesn't have to be perfect. This is the one I copied. I guess the only thing left is if there's any little piece of fletching sticking out at the very end, just trim that off. I think you get the idea. There you go. I just want to show this real quick. As I was doing this fletching and pulling it, this broke on the end here. So instead of taking it all apart, I'm going to fix it. What I did was I just pulled a little bit more on this until I got a little bit of an overlap there, about an eighth of an inch, and I'm just going to wrap that. That should do it. It may come out when you shoot the arrow, So you may want to glue it down along the shaftment. But I've had that happen before plenty of times where it snaps right here at the end of the wrapping. The quill will snap there, whereas you're pulling if it's weak right there. But it's a relatively easy fix. And you can see it's not pulled very tightly. I'm just going to dig my fingernail in and try to pull it that way. Just press my fingernail in there, pull on it. And that's it. Okay, I've got the heat gun going. The temperature is dropping pretty quick. I'm just warming these up a little so they'll dry faster. And you can see the water is still in the bowl. That's pretty much it. I'm just going to run some warm air over these fletchings for a little while, maybe 5 minutes, to get the glue set up. Fairly dry. That's it. Hope you can see that.